for his 5 years in One Direction, and the nearly 2 years since they went on hiatus, Niall Horan has been linked to a string of beautiful women. But while his bandmates Harry Styles, Liam Payne, Lewis Tomlinson and Zayn Malik have had plenty of girlfriends since shooting to fame, Niall always insisted he was single, until now. Niall Horan says his debut solo album Flicker focuses on a secret relationship he had in One Direction in his first Bizarre guest edit since going straight. Niall revealed his incredible debut album Flicker, out today, was inspired by a secret relationship. He said it is written about one person. Most of it is. There's obviously songs that are not particularly about anything, just scenarios I've made up in my head or situations I've seen among my friends. But yeah, for the most part it's about that one person. I live most of my life out of the public eye. I try to keep as much of it shut as possible, because if you let it out, people start asking you loads of questions and it becomes uncomfortable. Niall Horan tries to live his life outside of the public eye. Niall wrote Flicker because he had trouble with speaking about his emotions. That's why I wrote the album I did, because I'm not the greatest talker in terms of emotion. But I found that I'm good at writing it down on paper and putting it on the record. It's still quite a hard thing to do, but I found it better to do it that way. The 10-track album is filled with emotional tunes about a complicated relationship, with a few mega-romantic ones too. But Niall confirmed his muse is now an ex, adding him single now. Yep, extremely single. His mystery girl is not the neighbor's actress Olympia Valance, despite rumors they were close. Niall insisted they met through mutual friends and merely hung out at a barbecue. Niall Horan and Olympia Valance hung out whilst in Australia, but he's adamant they are just friends. Niall Horan reportedly dated Ellie Goulding back in 2013, and he was perplexed by the supposed love triangle between himself, Ellie Goulding and Ed Sheeran in 2013, when Niall was believed to have got together with Ellie while she was dating Ed. That reportedly inspired Ed's tune Don't. Niall, who also used 1D's hiatus to launch sports management firm Modest Golf, said with a laugh, "It kind of all happened without me knowing, and that was it really." Niall won the People's Choice Award for his solo single This Town earlier this year. Niall Horan's debut album Flicker is out now. I can't remember a specific time or a specific moment. It all kind of kicked off and there was a song written about it, apparently. Now Niall has his own heartache tunes to sing. Niall Horan latest single Slow Hands. Niall is overjoyed to be the only member of 1D to be up for an American Music Award as Best New Artist. He said it's unbelievable. It's one of my favorite nights of the year. This year, with a nomination, it's really cool, especially with some of the sick artists that are out. Niall Horan. Niall has been plagued by issues with his left knee and had major reconstructive surgery in January 2014. Now he needs an op on his right one, as it's been overcompensating for his left, but is struggling to find the time as his 2018 world tour nears. The former One Direction star had to walk with crutches after undergoing major knee surgery. He admitted it's still fed. "It's nasty. In my family there's a joint issue where the bones don't sit in the socket properly. That's the same with my ankles, my knees, my shoulders. Every time I do press-ups I get pains in my shoulders, so it's an ongoing thing. The whole process was excruciating. I was lucky that I did my rehab when I did it." Niall Horan said he was attacked by a squirrel in Battersea Park whilst playing football, having purposely stayed away from a dance sound. Niall said, "My music probably stands out like a sore thumb today. You're competing in the charts with the Weeknd, Ed Sheeran and Dua Lipa. It's tough. Life after 1D. When Zayn quit 1D, things were never going to be the same between him and the rest of the band." But Niall has revealed their relationship is now almost non-existent, admitting he doesn't even have a phone number for his old pal. He explained, "I haven't spoken to Zayn in a while. I spoke to him at Christmas, then I spoke to him again a couple of months ago. Zayn's Zayn. Not a lot of people would be able to say that they get in touch with him. He's the hardest man to get in touch with. He is always changing his number. Things couldn't be more different with his other bandmates, though." Niall has already showered gifts on Bear, the 7-month-old son of Liam and Cheryl. He said, "I've met Bear. I got him a set of golf clubs, so I have to drop them off when I get the chance. I'm getting everyone into golf. I'm trying to grow the game." Niall has maintained a close relationship with all of his former bandmates except Zayn. "As a start, I got him little trainers which have his name on the back. Little pairs of all the different trainers that Liam likes. Little Air Max, little Stan Smiths and stuff. Last month Niall saw Harry perform a solo gig in Los Angeles. He said we hugged it out, had a drink afterwards and had a bit of a chat. We talk every day but we don't get to see each other all the time because everyone's doing their own bits and pieces. Niall Horan has showered Liam and Cheryl's baby bear with gifts. Niall Horan does not say Malik's current phone number is for a reunion of the band in 2014. Niall said it's only been like 2 years or whatever, so I'm not worried about it. I'm not rushing it and I'm not worried that it won't happen. That will be music to ears of their fans. Touring is different this time around. Niall said it's a lot smaller entourage. I think there's 16 of us. We had 160 crew on 1D and 30 or 40 trucks every day, everywhere we went. It was like a circus rolling into town. My pals just unbelievable. Niall is the closest out of all the One Direction lads to Justin Bieber. And 2 months after the Canadian superstar axed the remaining dates of his Purpose tour, prompting concerns about his health, Niall says he is doing better than ever. Niall Horan is glad Justin Bieber was able to turn his life around. Niall Horan and Justin's friendship goes back to 2012. Niall said, I love that fella. He's mad brilliant. He's a different man, completely. It's unbelievable. He doesn't drink, doesn't do anything else. He's in good shape, keeps himself to himself with a smaller group of mates and gives me a shout every time he wants to play golf. Fair play to him. I think he's done a great job of turning it around. We kind of grew up together. Bismeet and Niall's Nuggets Awards. Niall is overjoyed to be the only member of 1D to be up for an American Music Award as Best New Artist. He said it's unbelievable. It's one of my favorite nights of the year. This year, with a nomination, it's really cool, especially with some of the sick artists that are out. Despite just releasing his debut album, Niall would love to collaborate with Shawn Mendes' home, with Family Down Under. He revealed he is keen to move there one day. Niall explained, I'm sure when I'm older I'd love to live in Australia. But that won't be any time soon. I have a place in London and I've got a place in LA. I'm living out of the suitcase for the next year. Duet, his album is out, but Niall is still keen for a collaboration with Shawn Mendes. He said the fans would love it. He's in the middle of his album at the minute, so if we can get something rustled up in the next while, we'll see what happens. But we'll cross that bridge when we come to it. Niall credits Adele for making British music go global again. Singer, Niall is just like everyone else when it comes to his favorite acts. As well as being a fan and a pal of Shania Twain, he said, oh, I love Adele, she is a dream. She's just an unbelievable talent and what she's done for British music around the world, she's just incredible. Niall found it hilarious when fans pointed out his album title Flicker looked awkwardly like a swear word. He said with a laugh, it does look like fair, doesn't it? But no, it definitely says Flicker. I did think that was quite funny. Matt Sucker for Montana reigning X Factor champ Matt Herry visited Bizarre HQ yesterday for a Facebook Live. He sang new single Sucker for You and his track with Enrique Iglesias Subimla Radio, which you can watch on my page now. He also took fans' questions, and revealed he is close to Love Island's Montana Brown. He said, I met her, she is a lovely, beautiful girl. We've chatted for ages at events and get on really well. Niall Horan reveals he has yet to meet Liam Payne's son Bear but will be soon. Cheryl says she hated pregnancy, but Bear's given her the best 6 months ever. Chris Hughes' pal claims he brags to lads about Katie Price texts Strictly judge Bruno Tanioli to miss first episode in 15 years. This Saturday Price finally reveals 52 Snapchat messages Chris Hughes denied he sent her. Mark Wright's sister Jess defends him over his weird American accent. Jamie Redknapp shows ex-Louise what she's missing in diving challenge.